Kidney disease is a devastating illness. It affects millions of people across the world and can lead to things like dialysis, and the risk of dying from it is quite dramatic. But are there things right now that you could be doing that can make a big difference in lowering your risk of developing kidney disease? Well, let's take a look at the evidence in today's video. As always, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Before we dive into all of the interesting and exciting data, the first question really is you have to understand how big of an impact kidney disease really makes. Across the world, kidney disease affects 9.1% of the population out there. In fact, if you looked at the data from 2017, 1.2 million people died from chronic kidney disease. As of 2017, 2.5 million people were already on dialysis due to chronic kidney disease. But if you look at 2030, that number is expected to double to 5.4 million people. So it means that we absolutely have to think of ways to lowering the risk of developing kidney disease. And who are the people that are most impacted through kidney disease? Well, it turns out it's the people that are the most vulnerable for just about everything. People with lower socioeconomic status. The less money that you have, the more likely you are to be affected. And part of that has to do with care to early access healthcare, care to high quality foods and other stuff. But looking at this, if you're watching this and saying, well, okay, is there stuff I can do? The answer is absolutely yes. And when we look at what causes kidney disease, in order to learn about how to prevent it, you have to understand what causes it. The biggest contributor continues to be diabetes. Now, obesity is tied to diabetes, high blood pressure is tied to obesity, but diabetes by and far is the largest contributor when it comes to developing kidney disease. So here's a really interesting study that was published in 2020 that was essentially a meta-analysis. That's basically saying they look at a lot of studies and pool all the data together to see what do all of these studies do. And in this particular case, they ended up looking at 104 studies, which is quite a lot of studies, and looking at over 2.7 million participants to arrive at their data. What did they find? Well, a number of things. Starting with nutrition, what they found was if you had higher intakes of vegetables, your risk of developing kidney disease was lower by 21%. Same thing with potassium, your risk was 22% lower. And if you're wondering what has potassium, well, a whole foods, plant-based diet. Fruits and vegetables are rich sources of potassium. So the more you follow a whole foods plant-based diet, the richer your source of potassium is. Now, this is not the same as people who already have significant chronic kidney disease. There, we have to monitor the potassium because as the kidney function goes down, they can't get rid of potassium. High potassium, of course, can be very dangerous. It can cause arrhythmias. It can stop the heart. What else did they find? Well, they looked at so many different variables that although they weren't able to accurately assess for them because not all the studies looked at them, what they were able to find were trends. And so those trends were in things like coffee, fiber, dairy, folate, legumes, nuts, magnesium, nitrate, plant protein, omega-3, vitamin B12, vitamin C, vitamin D, E, zinc, all had a lower risk. On the other hand, what had a higher risk was red and processed meats. Now, what about physical activity? Well, those people who exercise more compared to those who hardly exercise, they had an 18% lower risk. And if you're wondering, what does that mean? How much exercise do I have to do? It was very simple. It was quantified as at least 30 minutes per day. Look, you got 24 hours in a day. 30 minutes is very doable. And even if you can't do it at once, you can split it up. 10, 10, 10. Or 15 minutes in the morning, 15 minutes in the evening. One thing that really surprised me about the study, and I wasn't expecting, was alcohol intake. So what did they find? What they showed was that those consuming moderate alcohol intake, which is essentially one drink or less per day, had a 14% lower risk. Those who had excessive alcohol consumption, meaning more than 1 to 4 drinks a day, actually had evidence for direct kidney damage. That's irregardless of the damage to the liver, it's actually affecting the kidneys directly. So alcohol moderate, one drink or less per day, was actually shown to have a protective benefit. Smoking, on the other hand, did not have any protective benefit. In fact, both current smokers and people who had smoked in the past both had an 18% higher risk. And really the thought process there is smoking is linked to insulin resistance. And other things it does is it directly damages those endothelial cells lining your blood vessels. Those are the cells that help to relax the blood vessels, and it causes direct damage. It also creates these advanced glycation end products, or AGEs, which are basically linked to tissue damage by creating reactive oxygen species inside the body. So looking at this data, what are the things that you can walk away from and apply to your health right now? There are six real main take-home points. Eat a diet that's rich in potassium intake. It lowers your risk for kidney disease by 22%. What's that? A whole foods plant-based diet. Eat a diet that's rich in vegetables. A whole food plant-based diet lowers your risk by 21%. Follow the self principle and make sure that you're getting at least 30 minutes of exercise per day, and it lowers your risk of developing kidney disease by 18%. Alcohol consumption, one drink or less per day, lowers it by 15%. On the flip side, if you're a smoker, quit now. It's the best single thing you can do for your health right now is to quit smoking. So smokers and former smokers had an 18% higher risk. And salt. If you're somebody who consumes a lot of salt, cut it down. Once again, whole foods plant-based diets are naturally low in salt. Low salt diets are protective. High salt diets had a 21% higher risk. I want to thank you guys for watching. I would love to hear your thoughts on this study. Please be sure to comment below. And as always, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time.